Neutering a dog means removing his testicles. Here, we demonstrate the scrotal neuter technique, which historically was thought to lead to self-mutilation. However, studies have shown that there is no greater risk of this compared to the traditional pre-scrotal approach. Surgery begins once the patient has been prepared by veterinary support staff, been given pain medication, and is at an appropriate plane of anesthesia. First, a small incision is made in the scrotal skin over the testicles. One testicle is then pushed out through the opening and held in one hand while the surgeon removes fat and tissue from the attached spermatic cord, often using a surgical blade. This cord is a bundle of nerves, blood vessels, and ducts. Gauze can be used to strip the tissue manually. Some surgeons elect to create an indent with the clamp in which to set up the knot. The clamp is placed on the cord and the testicle is cut away. A strangle knot is now set up around the clamp. It is moved onto the cord and then tightened. Additional throws are used to secure it. The surgeon ensures the knot is secure and confirms it is free of bleeding and any other material. The cord is then returned to the scrotum. This process is then repeated on the other testicle, bringing it through the same skin incision. The cord is cleared of fat and tissue. Gauze is also used to strip the tissue manually. An indent is made to set up the knot. The clamp is placed on the cord, and the testicle is cut away. A strangle knot is set up around the clamp. Then placed on the cord. And tightened. Additional throws are used to secure the knot. And the knot is inspected before returning it into the scrotum. A veterinary assistant then splashes a small amount of topical anesthetic into the incision site for continued pain control. The incision can be left to heal on its own, or one suture can be placed in the center of the incision to assist the healing process. Either way, the scrotum is left open to allow any fluid that builds up during the healing process to drain naturally. Caretakers should, therefore, be informed that it is normal to see a small amount of blood-tinged discharge for a few days immediately after surgery. Finally, as with all of our surgeries, we place a small green tattoo to indicate that the dog has been sterilized. Here, we place it just in front of the scrotum. We then seal the tattoo with surgical glue.